In this episode of C++ Weekly, I would like to discuss standard bitset. But before I do that, I would like to remind you that my name is Jason Turner, and you need to check out the video description for info, for sponsors, and all kinds of interesting things going on. You should probably also buy a copy of one of my books. That's in the video description as well. Okay, so I recently had a patron, and this is an outstanding reason for you to become a patron so that you can ask these questions as well more easily, why there isn't an optimization of standard array for bool. Let's go ahead and dig in to what they mean by that. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains. Today we need tools that help us work quickly and effectively. CLion is a powerful JetBrains IDE for C and C++ that makes filling this need its main goal, integrating code analysis, refactorings, and a wide range of tools into your day-to-day development. The latest version of CLion introduces deep integrations with the ReSharper C++ Writer C++ language engine, performance improvements for the debugger, new features for embedded development, and enhancements for project models and build tools. Use the code CPPWeeklyCLion to get 25% off when purchasing a new CLion subscription or renewing your existing one. Vector of bool is weird. I did an episode about that titled, Why is Vector of Bool Weird? It is a packed set of bits. So the size of this thing, the number of bytes that it contains, is not directly related to the number of elements. And this is kind of difficult to actually observe, but that's the idea, is that a vector of bool is a packed set of bits. And you should go watch that video about what makes it weird if you're more interested in that. This patron was asking, if I were to create an array of bool, why is this not packed as well? Why does this take up 8 bytes where it could take up 1 byte? And I pointed out to this person that really what you want is standard bitset. This gives you all of the operations that you would want on a set of bits in a well-performing, convenient way to access them. We can access them with our index functions, or we can do things like return the current number of set bits. We can do bit mask type operations. We can check the all of, any of, none of kind of operations. We can set or reset all of the bits at once. We can flip all of the bits at once. All of these are implemented in as well of a performing way as you could want for them to be. So if I have a bit set of unknown origin, I can see here that the compiler is going to call the built-in pop count. And if I were to go another level up by actually telling it that I happen to have a CPU that has the built-in pop count instruction, then it will just directly call that pop count instruction, which is incredibly handy. And you can make this as big as you want to and expect that we'll see what, like 4 pop counts? Okay, 2 pop counts together added together, right? Pretty good stuff here. If you find yourself wanting a packed, efficient array of bits, then really what you want is bitset. And I thought it was a good time to do this episode because in C++ 23, this thing finally got a real set of updates and all of these member functions become constexpr. So you can use all of this bitset stuff, even at compile time, in C++ 23, and you can expect that you're going to get, otherwise at runtime, all the efficiency that you could want from your bit operations without having to learn all of those tricks from back in the day that you might have used. Anyhow, I hope you found this episode interesting. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, and I'll catch you in the next episode.